We're talking 700 kilometers of altitude. Opening a capsule that has to first be have its pressure adjusted. You know the history of what the agency did. What about what SpaceX plans to do tomorrow morning?
Well, this is a very exciting mission, whether it was a government NASA mission or what it is, which is SpaceX and the private entrepreneur Jared Isaacman paying for this. So it does not involve our tax dollars. The other three individuals going with Jared are SpaceX employees. So it's a really exciting mission. It is stretching the envelope, pushing out the barriers to what I know Jared is driving toward, which is a spacefaring civilization. You need to take new risks, and that's what they're planning to do here.
How radiation impacts humans, obviously also how Starlink laser beam communications manages at these sorts of altitudes. Laurie, where does it push us forward to? Ultimately, what does it mean for also NASA working alongside on these more experimental high risks projects?
Well, you know, one of the reasons SpaceX has been so successful is that they've taken things step by step. And we at NASA, when I was there, allowed them to carry cargo first to the International Space Station. After they developed this rocket largely with their own funds, we got a lot of confidence with that and then allowed them to take astronauts. Now they are taking astronauts beyond where the space station is to a much higher orbit and, as you noted, going on the first commercial spacewalk. We will learn, we in the government, from these activities. They've developed a new spacesuit. NASA spends a lot of money on spacesuits and takes a lot of time to do these things. SpaceX is showing us the way, and if it is successful, I think NASA will be not far behind in trying to embrace this and be able to utilize SpaceX ultimately for even more activities. They have proposed servicing Hubble. I think this mission is planned, as Jared initially, as a precursor to being able to boost the Hubble Space Telescope to an orbit where we could use it for longer scientifically. NASA has not yet opened that door. So if this succeeds, I think we'll see SpaceX back trying to
Laurie,
make that happen.
We got confirmation over the weekend that it's SpaceX to the rescue, that the two astronauts stranded on ISS will return in Dragon capsule because of the issues with Boeing and its capsule. How do you react to that? And how does NASA react to that long term?
It's surprising that the Boeing program, Starliner, has had so many problems when they were awarded both Boeing and SpaceX these contracts through the government. They got a lot more money. It's taken them now more than four more years and now not successful. That said, the point of competition is to drive and make things better, and we successfully have SpaceX and Dragon able to do this. So I think part of this story isn't really that the astronauts are stranded, but that we have this option with the Dragon to bring them down. Of course, we also have the Russian Soyuz program, which 10 years ago, NASA was more than happy to use as a backup. So it's a setback for Boeing. It's something that NASA had hoped wouldn't happen, but it reinforces the value of what NASA's plan has been. And frankly, all props to SpaceX.